see the white crosses at the top of the hill, where foreign winds do blow. The chill air is haunted and all is still, where the ghosts do gently moan. And young Tommy Atkins is with them, he never reached his 18th year, and it broke his poor mother's heart in two. She never saw her young son again. Mary Johnson would never wed through the passing of long years, yet the saddest grief must surely fade after long and bitter tears. But young Tommy Atkins stole her heart to take wherever he did go, and he lies in a field forgotten now, far away from where the flowers of England do grow. And with the eyes and ears of history, can we judge both king and pawn? And can we point the finger of guilt at the graves of those who were shot at dawn? Tommy Atkins was a daring soul, as brave as any man, but a scapegoat can't defend itself when it's made to carry the can. But the disease was never diagnosed as he marched out in the early morn, and in behind the disgrace of cowards when they had him shot at dawn. Does the conscience of kings hide a brotherhood of thieves that plucked the rose from the thorn? And can we wipe the blood from the fingers that had flowers of England shot at dawn? The swelling pride of history casts a shadow over graves where flowers once bloomed and took the wind, but now the winds have changed. A fabled path of glory, long trodden, carries on, remembering those who gave their lives, was condemning those shot at dawn. So praise the heroes, yeah, none but the brave. Three cheers for our favourite sons, and a blood red poppy for a red English rose, and a curse on those cowards who were shot at dawn. But it's the simple question of life and death, one we can all understand. Will the question be right?